Hi again, and welcome back to the Chambers Connection, Work at Home Solutions, the Confessions of a Work at Home Junkie. And again, my name is Janice, and thank you so much for listening to my blog, and for those who have read my blog on WordPress. I really appreciate it, and I enjoy talking with you. Love reading the emails and the responses that I receive from each of you. So keep it coming. That's what I'm here for, and this is what I love doing. Now today, I'm going to do something a little bit different. I have been telling you about all of these great jobs that are available online for you to work from home. And majority of them are customer service jobs. Okay, not all of them. I will be getting into some non-customer service jobs later this month, hopefully. For those of you who love to type or you do not have any skills at all. So we're going to get into all to that. But in the meantime, first and foremost, because I think most of you visit my page and my website because you're into customer service work and you want to do phone work from home. Okay, now for all of you well-seasoned veterans out there who've been working from home for years like me, or if you've been working in the brick and mortar jobs for years in customer services, this video may not be for you. But then again, you might just learn something a little bit extra, because today I'm going to talk about how to improve your customer service skills. So if you do not have any, and you have never worked on a customer service job before, whether in brick and mortar, or you're trying to venture out and you're a young mother or a student, senior citizen or retiree or young dad, stay-at-home mom, stay-at-home dad, and you want to do something a little different so you can generate an income and to help your family. So this is what this video blog is all about, okay? First, we're gonna talk about customer service. When you're dealing with people, whether you're on the phone or in person, you gotta keep your cool. I know, it's not easy, because you are going to run into all kinds of people who have all kinds of problems, and guess who they're gonna take them out on? You! That's right. Now, I've done it. I remember when I had to call the cable company because, they know why. All of my customer service training just went right out the window because I was no longer the servant, I was the customer, and I demanded justice. And the agent on the other line received all of my guilt into his ear. But you know what I realized about that call? This gentleman was one of the best customer service representatives for my cable company. He handled it so professionally and with so much grace and showed me so much empathy until I had to calm down. I ended up getting a discount though. Mm-hmm. That's right, because they were wrong. But nevertheless, he knew how to handle me. Anybody can do that, they deserve a raise. Now back to us, okay? Now we're on the other side of the phone. We are in the receiving line. First thing you have to remember is clear communication is very important. Communicate. Mm-hmm. In order to do that, you first need to know exactly what the customer needs or wants. You're gonna have a script 9 times out of 10, but I tell you this, you're not gonna be able to go by that script all the time. Cause what's that phone ring? Ding, ding. Hi, this is Janice. Thanks for calling the Chambers Connection, Working on Solutions. How may I assist you today?
I'm calling because I don't have a job. And I want a job today. And I want you to help me to get started today. You promised you would, and here I am, I'm still not working.
May I have your name, please?
My name is Mr. Complainer.
Mr. Complainer, I am sorry that you're not having a good day. Let me see what I can do to assist you, okay? So let me pull up your information and take it from there, okay? The main thing that he communicated was he wasn't unhappy. He was not happy. He wanted a job. Evidently, he went to my website. I'm just using my website as an example to look for a job, and he could not find one. Is that my fault? Did I not work diligently to post jobs online every single day? No, it's not my fault. He needs some training. He needs some skills and he needs some directions, and maybe he's applying for jobs that he is not suitable for. Can I call him an idiot? Can I say you're slow? You're not good enough for this? No. That is a customer. I want him to come back. And I want to treat him well while I have him on the telephone. So all of my little personal opinions, they do not count. And I do not give them to him. They might float around in my head. I'm human. But the bottom line is communication. And you can't communicate if you don't listen. So those were two skills at work right there. Communication and listening. Okay? All right? Now, it's essential to communicate. Even if you're writing them, send them an email. Let them know what's going on. And most of all, the second point is listening. Now, let's go a little bit, talk a little bit more about the listening skills, okay? Yeah, I'm reading it. That's why I'm not looking at you. Listening skills are just as important as communication. You know, we have to listen carefully to the customer to know exactly what he or she needs. This customer needed a job. He needed help. He needed me. And here I am. So, once I listen, I received all of that. And you know, if you're in person, you can always nod and make eye contact, but when you're on the phone, you let them pour it all out. And then you show empathy. That's number three, always empathize. I certainly do understand how you feel, Mr. Complainer. I would be upset too. Put yourself in their place. Let them know I don't think I'm better than you. Don't make them feel like you never felt that way, because you have. And if you were the customer, you would be upset too. Empathize. People love it when you get down on their level and feel like they do. No, we're not going to go there. Misery loves company. Uh-uh. Don't even think it. All right? And most important, we do have to maintain self-control. I worked for this company a few years ago. And that was during the times of terrible tornadoes and hurricanes were going on in our great state of Alabama. His cable went out. Always a cable company, right? Cable was right out all over the state for this company. When he called in and complained, he got me on the line. Evidently, he was not happy because he was speaking to a woman of color. The N-word came out of his mouth. I maintained self-control because I knew I was being recorded and I was getting paid. Therefore, I said, unfortunately, I will have to release this call. Please call us back when you're able to communicate properly. I hung up. You do not have to take abuse when a customer calls you, but you do have to maintain your self-control. Of course, it made me angry. But I got over it because the next call came right in. And the person that was on the second call, I did not want my attitude to reflect what happened on the first call. You keep moving. Maintain self-control. Because if you don't, you will not be able to keep a job. You can't go off on these people and say, oh, you so-and-so, blankety, 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 blank. That's not professional. That's not what the company is paying you for. Maintain self-control. Here's a little secret. You don't live with these people on the other line. You don't have to go home to them each day. They're your paycheck. When you hear them complaining, think about money and you paying your bills, and you will get through that call, and that will help you to maintain your self-control. And finally, because I'm not going to go into all of these today, always be positive. Never talk down about the company that you're representing. For instance, I worked for Sears. I took calls for Sears at home for a seasonal job. You would think people who shopped at Sears would have a little bit more self-respect and not say and do some of the things that they do. Now, Kmart, I can understand. But even if you know when the company is wrong as far as overcharging them or charging their debit card or credit card twice, you cannot say, well, you know, we've had this problem all day. I don't know what's wrong with Sears. You're representing the company. And if you talk about the company you represent, you're talking about you. Not only is it unprofessional, it is kind of ignorant for you to do that. Okay? All right. Those are just a few of the tips that I want to share with you today. and I hope that they're working for you. Now, later during the month, once this, I'm going to teach you how to pass a typing test, because some jobs do require that. Now, if you have any computer experience at all, you already know how to operate a keyboard. But if you want to go into data entry or transcription, you will have to be able to, make a decent score on a typing assessment and to prove to them that you're able to type and keep up with pace. Now, all of us are not customer service people. Some people like blogging or typing or working behind the scenes. Great. There is something in the workplace for you. Everybody's not a people person. And there are many people who are not people persons, but they know how to fake it so they can get paid. My hat goes off to you. I say hats because I wear so many. Okay? Well, the good news is I do have an orientation today, a webinar. I have managed to obtain 2 more work from home jobs. And I guess a lot of you, my listeners and my viewers and my readers say, how does she always get all these jobs? Number one, I am qualified. I've been working from home for over 10 years. And not only that, I worked in customer services for over 25 years. Most of my jobs, brick and mortar and online, were related, centered around customer service. My typing skills are up to par, but I do know my customer service skills and I know how to use them. And I will be teaching you what to say and what not to say during the interview. Yes, these companies are interviewing you over the telephone these days. It's a real job, what you expect. If you don't know what to say, you will not get the job. But thank you so much for listening today. It's always a pleasure to help you. And please remember to visit my website, thechambersconnection.com, and like my page on Facebook, The Chambers Connections Work at Home Solutions. And please look at all the links that I have listed below. These companies are hiring and they want you. But you'll never work for them if you don't click on the link and apply, okay? Take a chance. Take a leap of faith. See what you can come up with and come back and tell me the good news. Thanks again for listening. Have a great day, y'all. I gotta log in and go to work. Yes, I do.